Now, before we can do our next song, I think it's really important that you understand the testimony behind it. And it is a testimony of God's faithfulness to me. My husband John and I will be married 20 years this August, and we have a 16-year-old daughter, Taryn. And when Taryn was 3.5 years old, we found out that I was expecting twins. John and I were just thrilled. But soon after we found out the good news, I began having complications. And at 3.5 months, I had a miscarriage. The strange part was, I only lost one of the babies. For some reason, another one just held on. But I still had complications. Now, John and I had to readjust our thinking, obviously. We had twins, now we have one. And we realized God knows everything. He knows what's best for us. So we were just so glad to have the one. But because of my complications, we continually had to see the physician at least once a week. And at one of my office visits, he said, you know, I really think you and your husband ought to go up and see a specialist in Columbus. I was like, well, okay, so we did. While we were there, the specialist was giving me an examination, and he did an ultrasound. And he was able to see the whole baby. He saw the head and the arms and legs. He could see the heart beating, and everything was like really good. Everything was exactly the right size and the right weight. And he said, you know, I don't think I know why you're here. And I said, well, I guess because I'm a high-risk pregnancy, and my doctor just wanted to make sure, things are going okay. And he said, So he kept looking and looking, and about the time he was finished, he said, ah, I know why you're here. There is no amniotic fluid around the sac. Apparently, it had all drained out when I lost the first baby at 3.5 months. And because of that, the baby's lungs would never be able to develop properly and would never be able to breathe on its own. So they said, I suggest, because if you continue with this pregnancy, you are going to get a chance of having a real bad infection to the point it could cost you your life. So he suggested that we terminate the pregnancy immediately. John and I were like, you just told us that everything was right about this baby, and just because there's no water around the sac, you're saying we should abort it? He said yes. All he understood that if the best thing to do, it would come to no good. Well, I'm sure he did give us the best advice that he knew, but John and I knew a healing God, a miraculous God, and he was able to take care of this entire situation. So we went home and we prayed. And I remember asking the Lord, I said, Lord, you have shown me many things in dreams. And tonight I'm going to go to sleep trusting that you're going to show me something about my baby, whatever it is I need to know. And I went to sleep. And sure enough, I had a dream. And in the dream, a man appeared on my right side. And he was standing in front of a nursery window. But the nursery window was all fogged up. So he handed me this rag, and it's also kind of like an eraser, and he said, wipe with this. So I began to wipe this fogged up nursery window more and more, and the more I did it, obviously, the more clearly I could see inside. And then the man disappeared from my right side, and he appeared inside the window holding a baby. And this baby was wrapped in a baby blanket. And he said, by my stripes, you are healed. That she belongs to me. And I woke up and I told John about the dream. But I was totally convinced that was not from God. Even though I'd asked, I just couldn't believe it because I knew he could heal my baby and he could take care of me all at the same time. Well, we continued with the pregnancy and I continued to have problems. And one evening, about 5.5 months later, I look in the mirror and my skin is starting to turn actually green. And from everything that the doctor had told us, infection was beginning to set in. And I realized at that moment that God is sovereign. It didn't matter if I didn't understand. It's just the fact I had to believe. So I went in and I knelt down and I said, Lord, if this is truly your child to take, then I'd only ask that it would be as quick as possible. Because Christmas was coming up and I hadn't been able to care for my 3-year-old for a very long time, and I wanted to spend Christmas with her. And no sooner did I say that prayer, when I got up, I went immediately into labor. And it was a very painful labor because, you see, since there was no water, all that could push the baby with was my own blood. And I remember lying in the hospital, and the nurse said to my doctor, if we don't take this child, she's going to bleed to death. And he said, well, let's go ahead and set her up for blood transfusion. She's probably going to definitely need that. But I want to hold off as long as I can and see if we can get it to come as natural as possible. Well, a good bit of time passed, and about the time I couldn't take any more, I was able to deliver. And the nurse walked in holding a baby blanket, the baby blanket that was in my dream. And she said, wrap her in this. And that's when I realized. And I said to my husband, it's finished. Then I was immediately put to sleep. And the next morning when I awoke, the same nurse who had been with me the day before in the labor room came in crying and sobbing and just hugging me. She said, I cannot believe with all you've been through that you're going to go home today. You didn't need a blood transfusion. You didn't need anything. And I can't believe you're going home. And I remembered so well saying how I remembered the dream so explicitly. By my stripes, you are healed, but she belongs to me. Believe that you.